Hi, Python sets, symmetric difference. There is a brief introduction on set is given here. You can go through it. We will move directly to the task. So the task is given two integers m and n, print their symmetric difference in ascending order. The term symmetric difference indicates those values that exist in either m or n but do not exist in both. Let's look at the input format. The first line defines the number of items in set A. The second line is the actual items in the set A which we will be getting as input. Again, the third line is the number of items in set B, and the fourth line is the actual items that will be in set B. Okay, let's go to the code. We take these inputs. M is equal to input, and A, which is equal to, again, input, but these are multiple inputs in a single line. So we will use a split function. And this split function will store the items in a list, but it will be in string format. So I'll convert it to integer format by passing it to a map function. So map of int comma input dot split. Okay, and now I pass this map function to a set function to convert these items to a set object. Okay, the same we'll do for the second set as well. I'll just copy and paste and change this m to n and A to B. Now we got the required input. Now let's do a symmetric difference. So what does it mean? So we want to print what's there in A which is not in B, the first case. So let me use the set operation A minus B, and also we need to print what is there in B, but it is not in A. So I will do that with B minus A. Now we just need to combine these two outputs and print it line by line, sorted. So let's see the output here. Yeah, so we got 9 and 5, 11 and 12. Okay. So let's combine this output. Let me do A minus B dot union of B minus A. Okay, so again we are using a set operation union function which will combine the output of A minus B and B minus A. Now we need the result sorted. So I'll pass this entire operation to a sorted function, and I'll store it in a variable result. Now we'll loop through this result for item in result print item. Okay, so that's it. Let's run the code. Yeah, so we got required output. Let me submit the code. Yeah, so it passed the test cases. So that's the solution. If you like the video, hit the like button, and if you like the content, subscribe to the channel. Thank you.